sisters. This is Brother Patrick, your most favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are doing all right. I've been here praising the Lord. I got another bottle of oil. I was going to ask you guys, my brothers and sisters in Christ who are anointed in the Lord, to pray in agreement with me over it here in a minute, to make a new batch of prayer oil. Praise God. And the sister who's Sister Pat down in Charlotte, North Carolina, she wants me to keep reminding all those of our October the 10th. It's our end times conference, and I'll be preaching, praying for people to receive words from the Lord, words of wisdom, words of knowledge, prophetic words for people, prayers for healing, prayers and preaching. I'll be preaching to how to be, you know, to become rapture ready, revival, repentance. We'll be having a fellowship dinner before that. Starts about 5 o'clock. I posted the flyer, but Sister Linda Kirby will be sharing and discussing, having a discussion about the rapture, pre-tribulation rapture before my part. But we'll be having a meet and a greet and all this stuff. I'll be bringing copies of the book that the Lord gave me to write. I'll be giving away. And thank the Lord, we have over 50 people already coming. And I'll be giving away books to everybody that comes. And also we'll have making up. That's why I need to make up. I've got people who wanted oil to be sent out for me here. And then also I'll have oil there at the at this conference and fellowship dinner and all that, October the 10th in Charlotte. If the RSVP, if you want to eat the dinner, the RSVP is October the 5th is coming up. So if you could just please email Sister Linda Kirby. Her email will be below this video. You can also message me on here and I can email, you know, forward you to her. If you're like on a mobile device, someone was telling me the other day, which I mean, I should know it, but I don't normally use a mobile device, but I, on a rare occasion I do, you know, you can't see like what's below the video and stuff. So if you can email me at neartochrist, maybe I'll put a bubble on here, Sister Linda Kirby's email and my email on a bubble on here so you can just read it and then copy it. Let's pray. Let's pray right now, brothers and sisters. You know, the Bible says to enter his gates with thanksgiving is in your hearts and enter his courts with praise. Let's thank him. This is the Rochester children and the Matthews children singing here. Let's be thankful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord if you've been blessed.
Precious are
Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes, God, you've been good.
We have been blessed. Oh, yes. We have been blessed, brothers and sisters. We've been blessed. Hallelujah. We've been blessed so much. Praise God. Praise God, brothers. Thank the Lord, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Bless his name, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah.
He's more than I need. I can never describe his goodness to me. You ask how I make it day after day. There's only one thing I can say. It's been a long journey, but I have been blessed. Walking with Jesus, I have no regret. He is so good to me, I must confess. The way has been long, but I'm blessed. All that I need, I find at his feet. When I'm hungry, he feeds me with manna so sweet. When my soul is weary, he gives peace and rest. All I can say is I'm blessed. It's been a long journey, but I have been blessed. Walking with Jesus, I have no regret. He is so good to me, I must confess. The way has been long, but I'm blessed. Now I've had my share of sunshine and rain. My days filled with laughter, my eyes filled with pain. But every mile as I travel this way, the journey is sweeter each day. It's been a long journey, but I have been blessed. Walking with Jesus, I have no regret. He is so good to me, I must confess. The way has been long, but I'm blessed.
Brothers and sisters, let's praise the living God. Let's thank him, brothers and sisters. Let's thank him. I ask you to come in agreement with me, brothers and sisters, to pray over this oil too. You know, I try to have the oil when I do my praise and worship, when I remember to bring it out, because it's a point of contact, brothers and sisters. It's like for those who don't know, the Lord instructed me to make this anointing oil, especially because when we have the internet, people are scattered all over the world, and we're not together physically to hold hands or lay hands on each other and pray. All the people, the anointed brothers and sisters of faith, we come in agreement. It's like Paul with his aprons, his handkerchiefs that he sent out, the shadow of Peter. We come in agreement and pray over this oil, and this is a prayer of point of contact, that as if I myself and all those who prayed in agreement are there laying hands on you. You know, hundreds of people are praying when I make a video. Sometimes, you know, there's a couple of thousand people that watch it. I don't know how many out of those guys pray, but a huge amount. It can be 1,000 people prayed over this oil. Coming in agreement with what I'm going to pray right now. I ask you to come in agreement with me to pray over this new batch of oil, brothers and sisters, as a point of contact. Whoever would use it, as if we were there laying hands on them and come in agreement with them with praying. As the Lord Jesus Christ, as any of you, touch in agreement, bind on earth, it'll be bound in heaven. And what you loose on earth, you will loose in heaven. So let's come in agreement, brothers and sisters, right now. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, my Lord and my God, we lift your holy name in this place, Lord. Hallelujah, Father, we worship you, we worship you. We worship you and we praise you, Father. Hallelujah. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord. Hallelujah, Father. We just declare victory victory, victory right now in the name of Jesus. We come in agreement right now in the name of Yeshua, HaMashiach, whoever would use this anointing oil, Lord God, as if we're all there praying with them. We decree and declare that they are healed by the stripes of the Lord Jesus Christ. They were healed. Hallelujah. We agree that they are delivered from all torment, all torture, all demonic activity would cease and desist immediately right now in the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that all the power of the enemy is broken by the blood of Jesus Christ, Lord, and we just use this anointing oil as a point of contact, of faith. For your word says one can put 1,000 to flight, two can put 10,000 to flight, Lord. Lord, so how many can 1,000 of your saints put to flight, multiplied to 1,000 times? Lord God, hallelujah. 1,000 times exponentially, Father. We thank you, Lord. The exponential effect of the prayers of your faithful, faith-filled saints. So, Father, we come in agreement right now. And that's just what I'm hearing from the Lord, brothers and sisters. I've made this oil before and asked you guys to pray. We prayed for healing and all those things. But right now, which I'm going to pray more, but the Lord is just arresting me to talk about deliverance and faithfulness. And the Bible says, faithful is he who has called you. Hallelujah. And the Lord is faithful. Hallelujah. He is faithful. And he wants us to be faith-filled. Hallelujah. And faithful. Hallelujah unto him. Father, we just come in agreement right now. Whoever would use this oil, Lord. And that's just what I'm hearing from the Lord right now. We come in agreement right now, Lord. Whoever used this oil would have become faith-filled in the name of Jesus. Faith-filled. Full of the faith of God. Hallelujah. Supernatural faith. That's what I'm hearing from you. There's the gift of faith. Separate from the other faith. The Bible says to every man is dealt the measure of faith. But there is the gift of faith. One of the 9 gifts listed in 1 Corinthians chapter 12. The gift of faith. And that gift of faith is a supernatural kind of faith. For the working of miracles. For raising the dead. Hallelujah. For casting out demons. A supernatural level of faith. And that's what the Lord is just arresting me, brothers and sisters, about. Excuse me, because we've been worshiping the Lord here. And, you know, the Lord wants us to be always, you know, soft-hearted toward him. And brothers and sisters, this oil particularly, as the Lord has just done me, no idea in my mind before I started doing this, that this batch of oil, which I'm going to mark somehow. I'm going to tear up the front label a little bit and mark it on here, this batch right here. It's for the supernatural faith. Lord is telling me, I never even thought about anything like this. I never even thought about making the oil. Brothers and sisters, that was last year in maybe January, I think it was, or something like that, November. Last year, the Lord told me to make the oil. So many people that don't have a church. Their church is this ministry and other, you know, online. Nowadays, so many of the churches are falling away, brothers and sisters. You know, that the Lord wants us to have, you know, online church is what we're doing. Because there's so few people who are not, the churches that are not backslidden and lukewarm. So, I wrote on here, faith. So, this bottle of oil, the Lord is telling me that he wants to make people faith-filled and faithful. And the gift of faith. Well, one of those 9 gifts. And so, like I said, an example of the use of the gift of faith, not regular faith that you get saved with, because it says to every man is dealt the measure of faith, but the supernatural gift of faith, brothers and sisters, is for like raising the dead, casting out demons. And the Lord has spoken to me about spiritual warfare, so that's probably the biggest one that we deal with. Of course, raising the dead, of course. But lots of times it's also true, brothers and sisters, I mean, as it is true, that when it's somebody's time to go, it's their time to go, generally speaking. And we have to die of something sometimes. So the Lord doesn't resurrect everybody. He will at the rapture. But people die, and it's their time to die, generally speaking. And the Lord does resurrect people. And God could use you to resurrect someone. The Lord could use me. He could use us to resurrect people. As a matter of fact, I remember, now that I just mentioned about that, I remember... that, you know, Assemblies of God is an example. They track and try to document and track all resurrections. And it seems like they, I can't remember what it was now, but as of 2003, they have an average like 9 a year worldwide in Assemblies of God. But I mean, I don't know what it is now, but something like that. But for spiritual warfare is what the Lord spoke to me about when I was praying just a minute ago. For the supernatural anointing of faith for spiritual warfare. Casting out demons. Deliverance ministry. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. A word from the Lord I just got. So praise the Lord. And I've labeled this one separately. I still have another bottle here, like a half bottle. And I want to pray over this half bottle. I can make some out of this. But the general stuff. And I'll dedicate that bottle for the gift of faith. Supernatural gift of faith. And particularly deliverance. To be used of faith for deliverance and spiritual warfare. Let's pray over this one. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord God. We thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for the anointing power that this oil, Lord, this oil of the olive represents your anointing, Lord. For the word anointing, like charisma, is to rub on. Lord, and I will tell your people now, Lord, that what they used to do is they used to have the Romans would have these leather shields, and they would rub olive oil into it, Lord. And that was the chrismata, the charisma, to rub that oil into the shield, to protect the shield. Lord, we have our shield of faith that you've given us, Lord God. See, the Lord's tied me back into faith again, the faithfulness and faith-filled. You know, the Lord is funny. And always on time. He's an on-time God. We thank you, Father. Lord, I just speak right now, Lord, that this all of this oil would be faith-filled with your glory, with your faith, not as the world gives, Lord, but your faith, hallelujah, supernatural. Faith of God, hallelujah, not the faith of man, but the supernatural gift of faith, hallelujah, working mighty miracles, hallelujah. Even as in the word, Lord, in the book of Acts, you did mighty miracles by the hands of the apostles. You did mighty miracles, notable miracles through Peter, through Paul, through the other apostles, Lord, Father. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus, Lord. We just speak that this, let this anointing oil, Lord, be anointed. Hallelujah. With the agreement of prayers that we all have, Lord. And coming in agreement with our spirit, Lord God. Hallelujah. Let this anointed oil be filled with all the fullness of your glory, Lord, all the fullness of your faith, Lord God, of your power and your faith, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. For John the Baptist said in John chapter 3, Lord Jesus, you had the Spirit without measure. Hallelujah. Unlike Elijah, who had a portion, and Elisha, who had a double portion. But Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, you have the Spirit without measure. Hallelujah. Infinite power, hallelujah. You are all-powerful, mighty in battle, hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord, hallelujah. We come in agreement right now, whoever uses this anointing oil would be anointed with the unlimited power of the Most High God, El Elyon, through his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, hallelujah. Father, we praise you right now. We worship you, Lord. We speak right now, and the Lord still keeps speaking to me about deliverance, too, that whoever uses this oil, Lord God, would be for mightily used in deliverance and be delivered themselves or be used for the deliverance of others, Lord God, from all the power of the enemy, Lord. Lord, for we know that you've already done these things through your blood, through your stripes, Lord. But people don't have the faith. Hallelujah. Hold on a second now, brothers and sisters. I'm speaking a prophetic word from the Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. What I'm trying to give you is a prophetic word from the Lord, brothers and sisters. That's what all my videos are. Basically, the Lord has already given us complete deliverance from all the power of the enemy through his blood. But we have not obtained that complete deliverance. I'm not talking about just salvation. The word salvation and deliverance. Go back and look at the original words. It includes all of those things: healing, physical, spiritual, mental healing. It includes deliverance from spiritual warfare. It includes going to heaven. It includes, you know, having a resurrected body. It includes all of those things. Hallelujah. But that what I've just been speaking is from the Lord. But my people lack the faithfulness and the faith-filled life to receive all that the Lord has for us. Hallelujah. Forgive us, Lord, for lack of faith. For lack of faith for healing. Lack of faith for deliverance. Hallelujah. Lack of faith for all that is included, Lord God, in the finished work of Christ. Father, forgive us in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And Lord, even as that one ruler said to you, he said, help me with my unbelief. Lord, we ask you to help us with our unbelief, our lack of faith-filled living, and our lack of faithfulness to you, Lord God. Lord, we're unfaithful, Lord. We haven't had our first love in our mind as we should, Lord God. We haven't had you, Lord, as number one in the forefront of our lives as we should every day, Father. Father, we give you the praise. We give you the glory, Lord God. We honor you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we invite you, Lord God, to pour out your Spirit. Lord, we invite you, Lord God, to heal us, to deliver us, Lord God. And Lord, as you told people too, you said, according to your faith, let it be done unto you. Hallelujah. You told the woman with the issue of blood, daughter, be of good cheer. Thy faith has healed you. Lord, the virtue was always there. Lots of people touched you. Let me stop praying right now in Jesus' name. Let me just give this message. What the Lord has given me. When the woman with issue of blood touched the Lord Jesus Christ, you can go read about it in the Gospels. Jesus said, who touched me? And then Peter said, Lord, there's lots of people thronging you. There's throngs of people. What do you mean, who touched you? Lots of people are touching you. And Jesus said, no, somebody touched me with faith, for I perceived that virtue has gone out of me. See? So lots of people touched the Lord, but it didn't get healed. Virtue didn't go out of the Lord. The power was always there. But finally, that one with the issue of blood, she flipped the switch of faith, and she received her healing. That's why Jesus said, daughter, be of good cheer. Thy faith has healed thee. Now, brothers and sisters, you know, when I started out in the ministry, I started teaching on faith right away. When I first started, I started teaching Sunday school before I ever preached. Taught Sunday school for several months before I finally started preaching. I taught on faith right off the bat. That's how the Lord led me when I started my ministry. I used to call it walking by faith. It's my ministry until I started Joshua's ministry in 2012. And I guess the Lord is having me to teach on that. And I want to teach more on faith. Brothers and sisters, we can have, you know, all things in Christ Jesus according to his riches in heaven. If we would only believe, brothers and sisters. Our faith is usually what is the thing that is limiting us. Our faith in God and what he can do. What a mighty God we serve. You know, how great and powerful is he? That song, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. You know, he is a mighty God. He is the mighty God. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name forevermore. Bless his name forevermore. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to go ahead and cut this video off. It's pretty late here. I wanted to, let me put on the end here what I was just going to say. The Lord, if you guys have been watching my videos, you know that who watch it regularly, the Lord had given me a word about going to the Philippines in November. And, I mean, I knew it was from the Lord, but it was kind of in the back of my mind, ahead in front of my mind. So just the last few days, the Lord basically commanded me or seriously prompted me to go ahead and go to the Philippines. Like he had told me that I would go to the Philippines in November. So we will be going to the Philippines in November. So brothers and sisters, I'm not going to be able to come to Florida at this time. And I was going to come to Dallas too. I cannot come to Dallas at this time. Because I have to put all my stuff in storage and all that, get ready to go. And so the only place that we're going to be going to, as far as I know, unless the Lord tells me different, is to Vancouver. Be going after, in November, be in Vancouver. The last week of November, I'll be in Vancouver, Canada. Vancouver, Canada, because the Lord had told me to go there. We'll be in Vancouver, Canada, an American holiday of Thanksgiving. I'll be there that those last days of November. And on the last day of November, we'll be flying to Philippines, brothers and sisters. So I ask you guys for your prayers. And, you know, I wanted to go to those other places. But, you know, I have to obey the Lord, be obedient to the Lord. I'll be back. And by the grace of God, it seems like we'll go ahead and have our plan is to go ahead and have our child there in the Philippines. We'll be back after that, after a recovery time. So I'll be back here about the 1st of April, back in the U.S., brothers and sisters. So ask for your prayers. And I'll be making an itinerary. When we come back, we're going to be looking to go. And I'll be traveling to all those places. And the whole time I'm back here next year in the summer, be going to visit all you guys. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I plan to get to Dallas, Seattle, Florida, all those places, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God. And hopefully we're going to do some more of these conferences. Or whatever the Lord wants to do. It doesn't matter to me. So praise God. Praise God. And I thank you for all your prayers. And for the orphanages, of course, I've got to go there. The Lord had wanted me to go to the Philippines to do crusades and evangelism, crusades and revivals, and end times pastors conferences like I used to do. The pastors, like a whole, you know, say a whole denomination in a region, they have their regional meeting. I would come in and do a 2-3 day end time seminar and all this kind of stuff. And evangelism and end times and revival. And whatever that group needs. The Lord, I've done that for years before. So I'll be doing that again. Of course, we've got the orphanages. Got to work on those. And, you know, we've got to get some. We need to add new orphans to the other orphanage. I need to get some new house parents at orphanage number 3. So you guys to pray about all those things. And, of course, I need to make. I'll be making some slideshows of the orphanages. You know, brothers and sisters, I haven't. Don't mention it too much, hardly at all. I make those slideshows of the feeding programs, orphanages. You know, we have, by the grace of God, the Lord has been providing our monthly budget for the 4 orphanages. And, you know, we feed 1,000 poor street kids, 4 poor kids. Not all of them live, some of them actually live in the street, but I say their families live in a shack. If you've seen the pictures from the Facebook group, I invite you to join a Facebook group. If you have not, the link is below the video here. You can see that, you know, the there's no such poverty in the States or in Canada, as an example, or Europe, Western Europe, than what they have in the Philippines and places like that. You know, third world countries, Africa, countries in Africa, Philippines, places like that. Poverty is just is unbelievable. People living in shacks, no electricity, no running water and all that. By the millions, brothers and sisters. And, you know, we do what we can do to help. And to bring the gospel. And one way we do that is the Lord has led Joshua's ministry. As a little child would lead them, lead their relatives. And then we, you know, we feed them, teach them, you know, like a vacation Bible school. Teach them little songs and dances of, you know, Jesus loves me and all this kind of stuff. And read them Bible stories from books and all those things. And give them something to eat. And then their families start coming. And then we get them to come to the churches, the local pastors who are doing the feedings. Get them to come to their church. And so we've had hundreds of people saved, whole families coming to churches and all the churches that we're doing the feedings through. And the prayers of you guys, those who have prayed for Joshua's ministry, you know, in agreement with me and the pastors there and then the house parents at the 4 orphanages and all that, we come in agreement. And God is really, you know, doing it by Spirit. You know, we're having revival in several of those churches where we're doing the feedings. There's a spiritual revival going on. And that's from a fruit of our prayers, brothers and sisters. The food is just a little piece of that. But I ask for your prayers. And of course we need to always, I know the Lord does always provide the finances to do all those things. And every month we have a pretty decent sized budget to do the four orphanages and the feeding the kids, and then all of that entails with that, you know, them going to the places to feed and all that, and everything. It's you know, God has provided, and I thank the Lord for that. As you guys continue to pray for that, we can continue even do more as the Lord would give us the laborers. We always need more laborers. The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. We need more laborers always. We need and good laborers, solid Christian laborers. We need solid Christian house parents more. You know, I mean, if we're going to make more orphanages, like the Lord knows, I'd make orphanages all over the Philippines if I had good house parents. And then orphans come along. You know, the finances, I know God will provide. You know, God will provide the house parents, and then the orphans who have a need, I'm not worried about the money and all that, because I know God will provide. He's been providing, and He always does. See, that's a statement of faith, brothers and sisters. I know God will provide all of our needs according to His riches and glory, Philippians 4:19. So that's what we have to profess it and believe it and proclaim it. Anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, I was just thinking about cutting off this music I did at the beginning of the video because it's long, you know, but, you know, people, I hope that they don't want to listen to it. They can just skip it maybe. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. God bless you so much. And I thank the Lord for each and every one of you who have ever, you know, commented with a blessing comment, or, you know, a positive, loving comment, and who pray for Joshua's ministry and pray for, you know, me and myself as a person, or my wife, or, you know, our family. Pray for us and helped us to do the ministry. Every person has donated to help us do it. I want to thank you. You know, I can't do it without you guys. And, of course, the Lord is the one who's using me, and the Lord is the one who's using those who pray and those who have donated. And God is using us, brothers and sisters. You know, we're a team. The Lord is the captain of the team, and we are just players on His team, you know, like a basketball team or a chess game, you know, where each piece is on the chessboard, and the Lord is the one who is doing it. He's the one who is moving us where we need to go. He's the one who's making the strategies and plans, and we're just offering ourselves as vessels and whatever our part is. So I thank the Lord for that, brothers and sisters. I ask you to pray for our, strength to keep going forward in the Philippines. It's going to remote areas and all that. I used to do it for several years and all that before we had our son and stuff. And I can do it, but I mean, it's a physical hardship walking. You know, some of the places I go to, you have to walk like 12 hours, maybe more than that. It takes 2 days of walking to get there. You can't get there by even motorcycle. I could probably get to most places on horseback that I've been. Some places it's just so steep, I don't think you can hardly take a horse there. And a lot of those areas are in, you know, there's no police there. And then lots of places they have communist rebels there and everything else. And there's areas that are Muslim controlled areas. And I haven't been in the Muslim controlled areas because the Lord didn't tell me to go there. I'm not going to go tempt the Lord unless the Lord says He wanted me to go there. I've been going to the communist rebel areas, you know, because it's not nearly as deadly as the Muslim areas, but still. So I ask you for your prayers for those things. The grace of God, I will go back to those areas as the Lord leads me and do those things this winter here in the States. And brothers and sisters, I thank you for your support, your listening to my videos, all who would listen. You know, I thank the Lord for the opportunity to minister to each and every one of you, and to be a pastor to many, and also to be a friend to many, and many of you be friends to me. And it's what I've gotten out of YouTube is a whole lot more than I thought it could be, as far as having friends and meeting people and stuff through YouTube, and being able to minister to people, and then have people, you know, who have been, you know, friends with me and fellowshipping with me. It's been awesome. You know, and like I say, you know, you hear me, I'll mention probably every video I mention say something about the trolls at least once, but it's all worth it. Even if you get one person got saved from watching the videos, it would be worth it. And we've had lots of people, brothers and sisters. I don't know how many dozens or dozens and dozens of people have been saved just through this ministry on YouTube. You know, and then other people, of course, there's a few others who do, you know, who are ministers, and they've had people saved through theirs too. And it's a huge blessing. It's worth it. People baptized in the Holy Spirit. People's been healed. from the anoint when they use the anointing oil that we all prayed in agreement over. People, lots of people, dozens of people have messaged, and you know, I put it on the bottom of the videos I've made. Where they've been healed, delivered from demons, been baptized in the Holy Spirit, and had their relatives saved. They anoint, use the anointing oil, and anoint and pray, you know, over the doorpost of the house, and then the relatives that went through the house, they got saved. All kinds of stuff. I mean, you know, it's a point of contact. It's faith that represents our faith. It represents the anointing. It represents our covenant agreement as brothers and sisters in Christ. The covenant we have through the blood of Christ. It's all done through the blood of Christ and the stripes of Jesus Christ. And we are just acknowledging that when we pray and stuff. Hey, we're just saying, hey, we believe what you already did, Lord. You already did it. We're just receiving that. You know, just like when the Apostle Paul was at Ephesus, he was there in Acts chapter 19, verse 1, and he met some new disciples there, and he said, hey, have you received the Holy Spirit since you believed? You know, and then people talk about receiving your healing. That's what it is. God already gave it. He gave salvation. Did you receive salvation? God already gave us salvation. God already gave us healing. By his stripes we were healed. Excuse me, 2 Peter 2.24 or 1 Peter 2.24. I always get those two backwards. But by his stripes we were healed. From Isaiah 53, by his stripes we are healed. Talking about the coming Messiah. Then in past tense in the New Testament, by his stripes we were healed. We receive it. We receive salvation. We receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. We receive healing. We receive all things from God by faith. These are things that are obtained by faith. By faith, as I mentioned those other Bible verses, the one with the issue of blood and all that. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. And he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. So brothers and sisters, just have faith in God. To have faith in God. As Jesus even said when he was even referring to the rapture in John chapter 14. You know, and he had just told Peter that you're going to deny me, you know, and he said, let your heart not be troubled. He had just had scolded Peter, and then he said, you know, that you're going to deny me. Then he said, let your heart not be troubled. You believe in God, believe in me also. See, what did Jesus tell Peter? I made the message a few weeks ago. I think that's in Luke, where he says, Simon, Simon, Satan desireth. To sift you as wheat, but I have prayed for you. What did Jesus pray for him? That you would not lose your faith, that you would keep the faith. That you would keep the faith and not lose your faith. That's what Jesus prayed for Peter. Simon is Peter's first name. Simon Peter, as we call him, you know, is Peter's his Greek name. Simon is his real name, Jewish name. Jesus prayed not for him to be left alone by the devil. Not for him, anything else. Not for him to have a great day. Jesus prayed that he would keep the faith. Keep the faith. To remain faithful. And I guess I need to make more videos on this topic because I just stumbled into this topic as the Lord was leading me. And it's pretty late here, so I need to do more on faith. The topic of faith, brothers and sisters. It's really my own personal favorite topic, and that's what I started teaching out of. That's where revival comes. Really, from faith. Having faith. Complete and utter childlike faith in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm going to let you go. God bless you all. And I will, by the grace of God, it's been raining here for over a week. I think we had one. I don't even think we've had one day without rain. It even rained here on Wednesday. On Wednesday was the only day that the sun showed itself here in a week. And now we're having all this rain again and again and again. So it's about 12, 13, 14 days of rain. So. I think I'm back in the Philippines again during rainy season. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. God bless you all.